So I was wondering, what are you doing about getting some money for your big plans with the business? The bookies, I mean, not my...
Talking of business, why don't you mind your own? How about that?
Well, it's just if you get some money, you could always buy Leanne out. I mean, it's an option.
Yes, I know. And if I had the money, I would. It would be brilliant. I know that. I can't just flutter my eyelashes at the bank manager and expect for a bigger overdraft, can I? I'm not you.
Oh.
Anyway, why are you trying to keep Leanne away from me? He's the green-eyed monster rearing its ugly head.
Oh, you would just love that, wouldn't you? It would really appeal to your macho pride, that. Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, mate, but I'm not jealous. I'm just foreseeing problems, that's all. Anyway, it's not all about sex, Peter. You rate each other's goals, don't you?
Oh, of course we don't. Well, I mean, we don't. It's not really.
Yeah, well, Mystic Carla predicts blood on the betting slips before Monday.
Does she really?
Yeah, she does.
Oh, hiya, Dad.
Peter, thought I'd drop by while I'm giving Eccles her morning constitutional. Oh.
Morning, Ken. How are you?
Oh, very well, thanks, Leanne.
Good.
Ta. See? All very civil.
What exactly are you doing? Apart from making Peter cups of tea.
Oh, don't worry, I'm not being his beautiful assistant. I'm here troubleshooting the business because it's in such a mess.
Yeah. Compliments are flying thick and fast, as you can imagine.
Well, credit where credit's due. Or not, as the case may be. Well, I'll get that, shall I?
How did this happen?
Oh, don't worry about it. Actually, Dad, I was wondering if, hang on. Don't judge me for this, OK, please, but, how are you fixed for a small loan until I pay my tax bill?
Oh, how much?
Only, not too much.
A couple of hundred.
Well, I was thinking, you know, maybe a couple of grand, just maybe even a bit more.
Sorry, Peter, I just don't have that sort of money to chuck about.
All right, okay, well, that's no problem. I'll sort something. And I'd appreciate it if you didn't say anything to Carla or to Leanne about this.
Yeah, of course.
Thanks, Dad.
Oi, it's for you!
Busy. Oh, that's brilliant. Now, listen, mate, the pleasure is all ours. Yeah, you certainly won't regret it, all right? Brilliant. Cheers, mate. Bye. Get in. Another order straight in the back of the net. Smile. Oh, come on, I came good with that order.
What? I'm over the moon.
Are you still thinking about the bookies? What's the latest?
We had words this morning.
You want to grab that situation by the short and curlies and...
Look, I don't need any advice from you, thank you very much. I'm dealing with it, all right? Besides, I've got a plan to make sure that Leanne stays out of our hair for good. Mm-hmm.
Peter's on his lunch.
I know it wasn't Peter coming to see it, were you?
All right.
Look, I'll cut to the chase. I've got a question for you.
Well, I have a very short attention span, to make it quick.
Would you consider selling your half of this place to me?
Well, Peter never mentioned any of this.
It's a simple enough question, Liam, would you not?
Well, why are you asking?
Because. Look, it's untenable you working with Peter here as partners. It makes sense for everybody to have a fresh start, doesn't it?
Well, I don't know. I'll have to think about it.
You do know what untenable means, don't you?
See that window over there? I could quite happily chuck you through it.
OK. Look, you don't want to be here. Nick don't want you to be here. I want you out and I've got a solution, so...
Like I said to you, I'll have a think about it.
Leanne, I'll give you a fair price once I've seen the books cost.
Oh, and yeah, I do know what books are.
Right, Leanne, shall we? Have you had a good look? Yeah, think so. Come through.
It's just like you own the place already.
Right, so I've been looking at your end-of-year accounts the last couple of years and your incomings and outgoings for this financial year, and so I reckon I can offer you... that. I don't know what you're laughing at. I'm your flaming fairy godmother here.
wicked stepmother.
Leah, you don't even want to be in the same room as Peter. We all know that.
No, you don't want me to be in the same room as Peter. Can I borrow your pen? Now, I don't know about you, but I like numbers when they've got an extra note on the end. And after all, you are asking me to lose any potential future profits in this place should I turn it around, which I will, by the way.
Leanne, this business is worth Jack.
Maybe right now, but guess what? I'm going to make some changes.
OK.
Yeah. What are you doing?
I'm writing you another one. This time I'm going to double my offer.
Well, I'd say you got yourself a bargain there, Carla.
And I would say you're the luckiest cow in Manchester. So we've got a deal, then.
Well, I would say it's been a pleasure doing business with you, but then again, I never was a very good liar.
No. OK, my sister will be in touch.
Well, this big fat problem's all yours now. Anyway, thanks for the cash. Someone's off shopping.
Oh. Money. This fella having a nice time, and yet again, he goes and screws it all up.
Tasty, is it? That cup? Not many calories, I imagine.
Oh, no, cups are well fattening. Ready in gratia.
If you ever consider a career in stand-up, ask me for a reality check, won't you?
Who, me or him?
Both of you.
You used to chew your hair when you were stressed.
No, never.
Yeah, you did, when you were little. But now you're too vain, so...
Oh, I am! You're not vain.
You chew your coffee cup instead. Look, what's up? We've sealed the deal over the road. Grins all round.
Yeah, but how am I going to break it to Peter?
Get him indoors, and that's the easy part.
Yeah?
Would you like a cup of tea?
No, Fizz.
Right. Sorry?
He's going to go ape.
Who, Peter?
Saving a business that's going down the pan, that's the bit that you should be stressing about.
Oh, am I a complete and utter idiot?
Look, remember Muriel used to work down the Claremont?
Clark, yeah, of course I do.
Well, her fella Sweeney, he deals in gambling software. He's kitted out most of the bookies in Manchester.
With what?
Gaming machines, touchscreens, that sort of thing. Look, Peter could do with getting a couple of them in. And the software that he uses, yeah, it's all right, but he could update that and all. He needs dragging into the 21st century. Hello?
It's me, Leah.
Oh, hi. Yeah, come up. Oh, Hayley, Leanne. So, what can I do you for?
I thought the original director's agreement might be useful.
Right.
And there's a few other bits and pieces in there as well.
Okay.
Right then, I won't stay.
Just, wait, I know things are a bit difficult at work at the moment, but I'll find the money somehow.
For what?
So I can buy you out.
You are?
Oh, hey, love.
Leanne?
Oh, well, this should be fun. I wish I brought some popcorn now.
What are you talking about?
Can we talk?
Sure. I thought you were leaving.
Change my mind.
Can I please have a word with Peter on my own?
Oh, no way. I won't miss this for the world.
Sorry, is somebody going to tell me what's happening here? Please.
Yeah.
Well, clearly what your girlfriend hasn't told you is I've already sold my share.
What? Who to?